Up to this day, we treat depression according to monoamine theory. We believe that depression is caused by deficiency of neurotransmission, which can be caused by low levels of serotonin and norepinephrine and to a lesser extent dopamine in the synapse. So we believe that depression is caused by decreasing amount of serotonin and norepinephrine in the synapse. So how to treat depression? The most obvious approach is to increase the amount of serotonin and norepinephrine in the synapse. And drugs that cause increase in serotonin or norepinephrine in the synapse we call antidepressants. Selective serotonin reuptake inhibitors are the most commonly prescribed antidepressants. It's fluoxetine, fluvoxamine, paroxetine, sertraline, escitalopram, and citalopram. And to explain the mechanism of action of these drugs, we have to know how serotonin neurons work. So we have presynaptic neuron, synapse, and postsynaptic neuron. Serotonin neurons uptake tryptophan. Once tryptophan appears inside the neuron, tryptophan undergo hydroxylation by rate-limiting enzyme tryptophan hydroxylase, with formation of serotonin. Once serotonin is formed, vesicular monoamine transporter puts serotonin inside the vesicles, and in this form, serotonin is stored inside the neuron. But once depolarization occurs, neuron pushes vesicle into the synapse. We call this process exocytosis. As a result, vesicle becomes destroyed, and serotonin molecules come to the synapse. On postsynaptic neuron, we have numerous serotonin receptors. And once serotonin appears in the synapse, most of them immediately bind to serotonin receptors. With binding, they activate serotonin receptors, and activation of serotonin receptors improve mood and increase energy. Some of the serotonin molecules bind to serotonin 1-beta receptor on presynaptic neuron, which is autoreceptor. With activation, this receptor inhibits the exocytosis of serotonin vesicles into the synapse. So, this receptor provides reciprocal regulation. But what happens to serotonin molecules that simply did not have time to bind to any receptor? On presynaptic neuron, we have a serotonin transporter called SERT. This transporter uptakes free serotonin molecules and delivers them back to the presynaptic neuron, where the big bad boy monoamine oxidase A waiting for them. Most of the delivered serotonin molecules have a tragic fate. Monoamine oxidase uptake and destroy them. But some serotonin molecules are able to slip away from monoamine oxidase, and such molecules come to the newly formed serotonin molecules, thereby replenishing serotonin pool. Selective serotonin reuptake inhibitors inhibit the function of SERT transporter. With inhibition of SERT, the reuptake of serotonin into the presynaptic neuron decreases, so more serotonin molecules will remain in the synapse, where now these free serotonin molecules begin to bind to serotonin receptors, thereby additionally stimulating them. With time, because serotonin transporter is now blocked, in the same fashion, even more serotonin molecules accumulate in the synapse. The higher the amount of serotonin molecules in the synapse, the higher the stimulation of serotonin receptors, and thereby, potentially, the better becomes the mood and also the more energy increase. So to summarize, selective serotonin reuptake inhibitors inhibit the function of SERT transporter. This causes decrease in reuptake of serotonin from the synapse, thereby the amount of serotonin molecules in the synapse increase. And the higher the amount of serotonin molecules in the synapse, the higher the serotonin effect, and thereby the better becomes the mood and the more energy increase. Selective serotonin reuptake inhibitors are considered the safest antidepressants, but even they have side effects. First of all, excessive stimulation of serotonin receptors can cause sexual dysfunction. It's the most disturbing side effect, and also it's the number one reason why patients stop intake these drugs. Excessive stimulation of serotonin receptors also can cause increase in production of antidiuretic hormone, so-called vasopressin. And at some point, this can cause syndrome of inappropriate antidiuretic hormone secretion. Overstimulation of serotonin receptors can cause serotonin syndrome. If patient intakes just selective serotonin reuptake inhibitors, the chance for serotonin syndrome to develop is relatively small. But if we prescribe SSRIs in combination with monoamine oxidase inhibitors, now it becomes dangerous. Because MAO inhibitors block any possibility to destroy excessive serotonin molecules inside the presynaptic neuron. And with decreasing serotonin degradation, the total serotonin pool increase, and thereby the amount of serotonin molecules that presynaptic neuron release into the synapse increase. With increasing amount of serotonin in the synapse, the stimulation of serotonin receptors increase. And now, with such overstimulation of serotonin receptors, the chances of serotonin syndrome greatly increase. So, prescription of SSRIs with MAO inhibitors can be quite dangerous. So, to summarize SSRI side effects, first of all, with increasing amount of serotonin in the synapse, the risk of sexual dysfunction increase, and usually it's anorgasmia, which is inability to have a proper orgasm. By the way, this side effect is the reason why SSRIs are so good for premature ejaculation. Also, with increasing serotonin in the synapse, the risk of serotonin syndrome increase. And serotonin syndrome manifests with hyperthermia, muscle rigidity, myoclonus, and also it can cause rapid fluctuations in the mental status and vital signs. Also, we have to remember that prescription of SSRIs with MAO inhibitors greatly increase the risk of serotonin syndrome. Stimulation of serotonin receptors can cause increase in production of antidiuretic hormone by hypothalamus, which at some point can cause syndrome of inappropriate antidiuretic hormone secretion. In addition to this, SSRIs in patients with bipolar disorder can cause switch from depression to mania. Abrupt withdrawal of SSRIs can cause withdrawal syndrome, which manifests as dysphoria, GI flu-like symptoms, insomnia, depersonalization, and frank suicidality. Also, we have to remember that usually it takes 4 to 8 weeks for antidepressants to show clinical effect. Selective serotonin reuptake inhibitors are so good that they are considered the first-line drug for any condition where we can use them. First of all, it's a major depressive disorder, generalized anxiety disorder, panic disorder. Also, we have to know that in panic disorder, we use SSRIs for long-term therapy. But acutely, once panic disorder happens, we use benzodiazepines. Also, we use SSRIs for obsessive-compulsive disorder, social anxiety disorder, for post-traumatic stress disorder. They can help in case of premature ejaculation and also in premenstrual dysphoric disorder.